Okay, so first practical regarding to the introduction of NoSQL, as well as we discuss this thing relational database versus the NoSQL and some of the basic thing for installation of MongoDB. What is MongoDB and how can you install a MongoDB? Okay. Then theory concept we I think clear in first session. So we need to download. If you're not downloaded the MongoDB, so first of all download a MongoDB on your machine and required this step. Okay, what is MongoDB? MongoDB is one software you require to create a NoSQL database. Okay, MongoDB is a document oriented NoSQL database. It's not a relational database, it's a non-relational database. It's schema free. We discussed this thing in a prior session. Okay. Here this subject only covered the practical, but I need to understand what is a MongoDB and what is NoSQL. So it is a schema free database, schema less NoSQL data store that will be in a theory allowed to store any data like key value and pair in this document. So without prior knowledge of key or data, schema free database is a nothing but a NoSQL database. We discussed some of the type of database like it's covered the graph base or a tree base or family base. Okay, so that's all our example of data NoSQL type data. Okay, like this we discuss this thing key value and document as well as graph and object database as well as a tabular and what is tuple. We all familiar what is relational database and how can we differ from it with NoSQL. Okay, here we create a NoSQL document, so there is no prefix structure. You can alter it very easily and store any kind of data. Here some of the good example for NoSQL database are MongoDB. You can work on MongoDB, Neo4j or Cassandra or Redis. Okay, MongoDB organizes itself in a group of document, also known as a collection. So how can we create? Or a basic thing we required, we already studied in a DBMS, that is a relational database management system. So it is a different from relational database MongoDB system. Okay, MongoDB, if we cover the NoSQL, so it is related with the MongoDB. Here in a MongoDB we use a collection word. So previously we use in the DBMS table or database word. Okay, in a database we create a table. Okay, and in a number of table that in a relationship, so it become a relational database management system. Here in a MongoDB document word is covered. Okay, we create a document. So if we covered in a relational database, so table is a collection of row and column. Okay, here document, so in a relational database same thing, row is covered. Field versus column, that stand for if we are using in a MongoDB, so instead of fields use in a relational database column. And the collection isn't strict about what goes in it. That stands for it's a schema-less. Schema word, we familiar with the schema in a database management system. Okay, so this MongoDB or NoSQL is a schema-free. Okay, we already covered this step. How can we download a MongoDB? And I hope you downloaded this thing. So follow this thing. If you first download in your PC, so you require to check MongoDB available in your C drive. Okay, so just to check C drive, program file, and MongoDB is available here. Okay, then this is the version indication. So previously we select 5.0. Okay, so 5.0 version, and in this server we found this thing. Okay, here mongo.exe is available. So by click on a mongo.exe you can generate a MongoDB, or one compass is available to GUI interface. Okay, if you want to work on a GUI, so sir, also available inside bin folder. There may be file, but interested to mongo.exe. So all of you follow this thing, mongo.exe and mongod.exe. So what is mongo and mongod? Okay, here mongod is related with the server. It is a daemon server which will execute in the background and accept the request from mongodb. So it's work on a background. Okay, it's work in a background. And mongo.exe, here one file is available in a bin. If you click or open this bin directory, so mongo.exe is a command line shell, so which we are going to work with the with our database. So how can we work with the mongo.exe? Okay, for that you require to check all these things. Okay, in a bin directory mongo.exe is available, or second thing mongod.exe. okay, so clear about both this thing, mongod and mongo.exe. This one is a server that's running in a background. Then we check, so it took like a SQL prompt. Okay, if you work in a Oracle, so it look like a Oracle command. This is a command base. Again, we required a MongoD. So this is a server we required to run in the background. Okay, so all of you follow this step before start a programming. Okay, I will tell you whenever we start the execution or start with the practical 1 and 2. Only just to check the step right now. Okay, so in the PDF again, let's we check. If we open both the terminal, so open two terminal and traverse through path of a bin folder inside a MongoDB. So if you require to set particular path by using environmental variable, so execute mongod.exe command in a one cmd. okay, if we want to execute, so it's also run in a cmd. Initially it show some error. If any error will occur, that indicate order with a mongodb you need two folder. Here now execute mongod, so it look like this. Okay, waiting for a connection or a port. So let me check. Okay, here we required a connection. So if this type of a error will occur, so you required, you can see the MongoD is ready to establish the connection, and by this way, this is a client prompt. Here you can work or perform the command related to the NoSQL. Okay, so second internal is only for a command. Check window of MongoD.exe, it will show the connection accept. So then and then you can work. Okay, connection accept. Okay, here access control is not enabled. Read write access to the data configuration. And before that, we require to check connection is okay. Now, in a client room, you're required to check a DB. So, test is available, that stands for your connection is okay. Clear up to this? All of you getting this screen? Hello, student. Okay. So second phase, installation of MongoDB as well as we perform simple testing. So write in a command prompt DB and you can test. Also, you can test by using a user if user is available or not. So okay, so let's we move on to the next one. So second practical is related to this. Okay. Introduction of MongoDB and programming CRUD operation. Okay. So here describe of MongoDB. Here we use a NoSQL database shell. Already we install MongoDB, so we can perform this step. Okay. Installation of Studio 3D. Either if you not required a MongoDB, so second option is Studio 3D is alternative option, or you can work on a Mongo chip. Okay, so this is the platform you can run NoSQL command. Okay, and this is a learning command we will discuss in our practical session. So user creation, database creation, and viewing. Commands to insert, update, and delete, display the query. That is called CRUD operation. Okay. Command, we perform the insert operation, delete operation, update operation. Okay. Create, update, and delete operation. So this will be covered in this session. Okay. How can we work on a NoSQL? Okay. All of you open the particular prompt, then let me try with the example. Okay, how can we perform? If you require this software Mongo chip, so how can we install this? To download, follow this step. Okay, download Mongo chip by using link. Here link is available. So I send this link in your chat box. Here one window will appear. Okay, thanks for download Studio 3D. Okay, and it will start downloading. All of you getting this thing for Studio 3D? Hello student, I send in a chat box, so all of you check. It is a free interface, so installation completed here. Sorry, download is completed here. Here the installation for Studio 3D. So all of you follow this step. Okay. Okay, so after completing this installation, you generate a run Studio 3D as well as create a desktop icon if you required to create a shortcut. Okay, you can also run on a MongoDB shell. Okay, Now click on I agree and next. This is for a default password encryption. Okay. So after complete your installation, it look like this, okay? Here this is the welcome screen, okay? And if you required to set a path for MongoDB, so environmental variable and required to set where installation is available, okay? So set path. Here /mongodb/bin. Okay, if you check this thing, so path already we said program file mongodb/server/5.0/bin. Okay, clear. Then for second practical, if you require a connection, so I click on a new connection, you can create a connection, Mongo test and connect. So it's available, look like this. Okay. The welcome screen and full screen this. Okay, new connection. You want to write as it is name Mongo test, okay, and localhost. So I click on this. Mongo test is one connection on localhost. This is the port number. So if you require a read only, so click on this. Right now we are not select this read only option and save this. So it look like this. Mongo test localhost. Okay, now I required to connect for a next step. Okay, all of you check getting this thing or not. Yahan tak aap pahunche ki nahi, student? Hello. Okay. Now after click on this, you require a connect to MongoDB. Okay, so it will check the connection and the generator. It display the collection of user that you require to connect. Here admin, config and local. Okay, in a Mongo chip, if you click particular connection. So it will give the name of connection and click on a save button. Okay, then and then you display this thing. Okay, here it will display the all connection under the connection. So this is a connection under Mongo test and consider as a local host. Okay, local host look like if you install your XAMPP or VM server, so it's also covered the local host. That local host is useful to create any data or any table. So right now this is one software or a dashboard. Here you can create, but remember this thing, this is a trial and you can access only for 30 days. Okay, this is a trial version. If you required a details thing, how can we use, so all help is available here, help and learning, so you can learn from here. Free MongoDB course, Studio 3D features, all thing is available, all of you check in a free time. Okay, now click on this cell, Intel shell. Okay, here in that shell we can execute or executable statement or script. So we required this shell to create any program or execution for a script. Okay, clear student? So it looked like this. And right now we required to create a user. So how can we create a user? Here all things we perform by using a command. Okay, so this command is look like different from a DBMS command. Okay, if we require first to create a user, so let me try db under database. So I required a db dot create user. One option is available if you scroll down. Okay, like this, it required a parameter username as well as password. Okay, so I click on this create user. Then second thing, you required a curly bracket to perform operation. So starting and ending we use here username. So user, okay, then in a double quote I required a name. So this is my name. Okay, I write here. Second parameter, I required password. So pwd for password. Okay, and colon, then we required in double quotation password is 123. Okay, so I write password here. Then third parameter, role. What is my role? So for role you required, it is a group of characters, so it is a character set you can define by using a role. Okay, here we perform a role as a administrator. So user admin. Okay, and can change any database. So wait a minute. Here this is a DB type, so we use a DB as a database. Okay, then colon, I required a name as an admin. So write this way.
Clear? Before run the program, first of all check the syntax, because this is the first time syntax of NoSQL is something like different with the DBMS. Okay, so if not clear about the syntax, so all of you check. If you require to create a user, so like this. Now to run this query, this is for run a script, and this is for statement. Okay, so I run this query first time. Okay, so your script is look like this. Okay, and if I want to create a user, so let me check user is available or not. So first time we are creating with user RKS and password is 123. Step of a user is not available. Okay, and first user is available. Okay, by click or perform this operation. So here a script is generated, done successfully. Okay. If you want to save your script, you can save this. Okay. If you want to create a database, so already created database you can use by use database name, or create a database by again using a use keyword. Okay, now perform and copy this thing for a first save this script in a notepad for temporary. If you required a second step, like what is your database, so type db and run, so it will display successfully added a user. Okay, one user is added, and database name it will display admin. Okay, role of database is a user admin, any database, and db is admin. Clear? Write only db and test the connection. Okay, if you recently create a database. Clear, student? So by this way you can check your available database. If you want to create a next step, okay, so just follow here. User creation is already done, and we check available database. Database creation, how can we create database by user one command? Okay, how can we create? So type user and name of a database. By this way you can create a database. Okay, sorry, not user, use, and then database name if we required to create, as well as use this database. So switch to database RKS. Same type of activity you can work on a command. Okay, CMD. If this Studio 3D is a GUI based application, and if you required in by using a command. So already we install MongoDB, so run in a command. Okay, here we already open this thing. Okay, here you can also perform same thing, db, or you can write a user like a test. Okay, I want to create a new database test. So by this way you can create wait a minute here, use, not user, sorry, it switch to the database test. Clear student? All of you getting my point? Hello. हेलो स्टूडेंट, एम आई ऑडिबल? आप अनम्यूट करके बता सकते हो यहाँ पे. अनम्यूट करके बताओ मुझे.
यस सर.
ओके, तो व्हाट अबाउट रिमेनिंग स्टूडेंट, आपका स्टेटस क्या है? आपने इंस्टॉल किया, वर्क कर रहे हो आप पैरेलली? दो स्टेप हमने परफॉर्म किए, दो क्वेरी और दो कमांड NoSQL के रिगार्डिंग. फर्स्ट क्रिएट अ यूजर, तो आप स्क्रिप्ट से क्रिएट कर सकते हो, जैसे मैंने फर्स्ट स्क्रिप्ट लिखी. एंड इफ यू रिक्वायर्ड क्रिएट डेटाबेस, सो डायरेक्टली राइट यूज एंड डेटाबेस नेम. ओके, नॉट अ यूजर बट यूज एंड डेटाबेस नेम टेस्ट, सो स्विच टू द डेटाबेस टेस्ट. ओके, now create a collection. How can we create a collection? db dot create collection. Okay, if you required in a GUI based, so write in a GUI platform, otherwise you can write in a CMD. okay, db dot create, no need to write at two place. Okay, I only want to check, or this is the first time, so I want only want to show this perform in a CMD as well as GUI based. Okay, create dot db dot create to create a collection, then write here collection. Okay, and I want to create for student, STUDENT, student. Okay, so complete by this way and press enter. Okay, stand for first connection is created, collection is created here. Clear? Clear student to third step. Same thing you can perform in a GUI. And how can we insert a data in database? I'm talking about a DBMS. So all of you write down the query for insert the data in a table. How can we insert? First of all, create table and write a syntax, insert into table. How can we insert? Like my table name is student. All of you type a query to insert a data. I already shared the step. How can we download? Link is already available. Devers. So you can download and run. All of you send your query to create a table like a student table, as well as insert the data in a student table. I am talking about DBMS query, not a NoSQL query. Then I show you the comparison of DBMS as well as NoSQL. How can we write a query in a NoSQL to insert a data into database? All of you try this thing. आपको क्या करना है, डीबीएमएस में जैसे हमने टेबल क्रिएट किया था वैसे टेबल क्रिएट करो और इंसर्ट की क्वेरी लिखो, एसक्यूएल की क्वेरी में बोल रहा हूँ अभी। ऑल ऑफ यू गेटिंग दिस थिंग? राइट हियर इंसर्ट क्वेरी फॉर ओके सो इंसर्ट डेटा इंटू डेटा बेस। आई वॉन्ट टू इंसर्ट डेटा इंटू डेटा बेस। हाउ कैन वी इंसर्ट? डीबी is for database, okay? Dot student, I want to check student table is available, okay? I recently create but not fetch here, okay? That's why I required to create here first student database, okay? I already create here. So again I type use now I move from RKS to student. So second step I want to create collection. I repeat this step because need to create here okay. Here you can automatically generate this thing, create collection. So name of a collection I write student, okay. Then I want to insert a data, so db dot student, okay, dot insert. So it will insert into DB into the student database, okay. And I required to write first student ID, okay. So second is curly bracket required first S ID is a student ID, okay. This is the first element. Second element I required a e name, but SID consider as a one, okay. Then I type second element, so in double quotation I write a S name is a second element, okay. Write this way, then colon. I required a value for this, so this is a string value. Here we not define any database. Data type, sorry, directly you can write. So I write here RKS as name, okay. Completed this curly bracket and round bracket, clear. So if any error it will indicate by underline, otherwise remain true, okay. Then I want to create insert second database. Okay, so same way you can copy first, second and third, okay. So this is the second and name is RKS1, RKS2 and here 3, okay. If you required multiple data, so like in the third SID, I required age. So comma, age is one element. Okay. Again, you required in a double quote age. Then colon is required 23. Then write this thing variable dot this is one variable okay variable dot sorry space is equal to in this write a element This is this SID, so I write here SID double quote, then value for this 4. Okay. Then second is name, S name. I write name as a other name, okay. NKR. So this is a string type, so you required in a double quote again and if you required a combined thing like in variable if you required a third and fourth element as combined so you can combine this element and separate it with a comma like this way it is also possible okay. Now I write here again SID. Okay. 4. And remember this thing. I write here name as name. So by this way you can create variable. Okay. This variable is generally used to create a multiple data. Okay. And here list of the element completed so square bracket completed and semicolon we create this variable my stud okay now db dot student okay dot insert write this way and we required a name of database. So what is the, sorry, we required a name of variable. So we recently created a name of variable, my stud. Okay. And we complete here. Here no any error. So let me try to run this script. Okay. All of you clear? So look like this. Insert all the data. This is the cell output, document output, and this is a result whatever we run a particular query. Okay. Same way, if you required an update, so instead of an insert, write a update. All of you try this thing. Insert, instead of this insert, we required an update a database. So it will check and match the particular document. If document matching with a particular condition exists, then it is updated. Otherwise, it will generate an error. Okay, set a offset or a true. Then initially it will create if this type of data is not available. So it will create or insert. Clear up to this, how can we insert a data? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If any error will occur, so it will display here. Okay. So let me check here. Here 2.0 it indicates the data inserted. Okay. And remaining thing we are not update this thing. If we want to match. So here 00 we are not modified anything, so here 00 also mentioned. And if we remove any element, so here not perform any operation related to the remove. Okay, insert, this is for update, this is for matching the available value. If we required a this is a upsert and this is for update. And if we remove, so it will indicate here. Okay, so all of you try to update update the result as well as remove the result. So I copy this thing. Now I want to check display database. So by using show,
Am I audible? There's some internet issue. Student, all of you check by update query aapne check ki update case here all of you check update query we are performing this step okay for SQL sorry in SQL we the database and doing the data okay now let me perform update query and we perform delete query and display query okay so for update you required a db dot again click on a db click a db dot student because our database name is student then we required a update so update query is look like this update query update or any option okay so use here round bracket then the second we required a double quotation std student id sid we are using SID. Let me check. Okay, SID is available. So SID. Then second we required a parameter for SID. So we choose one, and this is one set. Okay. So to create this type of a set, you required a curly bracket. So starting and ending curly bracket here. Okay. Now second thing dollar sign is used then we set value we required update name okay instead of previous name I want to update so whenever you require to update you require this dollar sign to and then set a particular value okay set then colon I required to set in a student name so s name okay is my field and I want to change instead of RKS I want to write ABC okay so by this way double quotation again in ABC this is an element so covered like this what is the mistake so okay this is a starting symbol so again you require complete here clear so by this way you can update first name I want to update age whose employee ID is equal to 1 okay so let me check effect of the available update statement so db.update I want to update in a age so we set here age is equal to value 30. Okay, check in this previous one, I applied age is equal to 23 only for student ID 3. Right now I required age here for first. I change in a name and also apply the age is equal to 30. Okay, check here. Clear. So this is the update statement. And if you require to remove, so parallelly let's we perform a remove operation. You can do this thing, remove then particular field. Okay, which field I want to remove? So I write, this is for remove operation. Okay, db dot database name, then I want to update, or you can write a delete operation here. So delete is available. Okay, drop is also possible, drop index is available. Okay, right now I want to remove particular field. Only apply the update statement, then we perform a remove operation. Okay, again I type this thing. Let me explain why we require this. This is for last operation I want to remove. Okay, so to set, to update a value we required a set. If you required undo that operation, so unset. Okay, that here one option is available, unset here. So you can undo or remove the previous operation. Clear db.student, then I applied the update query, but this is work as a undo operation. Okay, so complete here by round bracket. Then only I want to update a age value. Okay, so if you want to update only age, so write this thing db dot student. Then update so write this thing again. Okay, now I want to update value only I use INC. Okay, so what is the INC in a NoSQL? How can we work with the INC? Is it not so? By this way, you can update a value. Previous value is 30, and I want to change this value as a 3. So complete this by round bracket. Okay, so this is all our, this all are update statement. You can update by directly set a value, unset a value, or INC is an atomic operation within a single document. If you work on a single document, so it is an atomic operation. Okay, this string in MongoDB 5.0 only possible. We are working on a 5.0 version. So we when you update operator like dollar sign INC with any empty operand, so expression and any it will use for empty update, result is no change and no upload entry is created. Okay, meaning that operation is no operation here. If we perform this operation for update, that stand for no operation. Okay, empty update, result is no change, no uplogged entry is created. Clear? Only we use we can use it in a 5.0 version. So we have 5.0 MongoDB 5.0 server. So this thing is only possible in the latest version. Then if you required a remove all this thing, so which query is useful, db dot student, here we required we are working on a student database, so student, then dot remove. Okay, here dot remove is enabled. So if I want to remove only employee ID, sorry, student ID, so right here std sid is equal to 3 or 2. Okay, it will remove only student ID is equal to 2, this element. Clear? Student is equal to Python not works, colon will work. Clear, all of you? This is for a remove and this all are update operation. Student, all of you clear this thing? So this thing, write result and match. Okay, here modified, then this all operation match, and one thing is remove. If no document matching with the particular condition, then we upsert. Okay, upsert is one option that's available. Previously we check here, so let me check. So that we remove this thing and again want to check a remaining thing. So I want to update a particular document that not match with my original table. Okay, so db dot student like this. If I taking this example, example db.student, then update a value. So here in bracket you required a value. Okay. First of all, I check for SID 3. Okay. This is the first step. And for SID 4. Okay, so this is the name you can indicate by double quote. Then this element is completed. Now I write a assert is equal to true. Okay, so what is the meaning of this thing? First of all, I write this thing and let me explain and complete by using the bracket. So this is the starting bracket and ending bracket. Okay. So for this type of a statement, you require again semicolon. And for remaining any particular field, write dot student I required a update. So first SID I change as a 4. Here we take SID, okay, and complete this element because this is one element consider, and dollar sign is used to rename or reset the operation. Okay, so right now I want to rename. S name, one column is available S name. So instead of S name, I want to write ST name. Okay, student name. So ST name, I change name here. Okay. Again, you required a double quotation for any string, and I complete this element with a bracket sign. Okay, curly bracket. Okay, now the statement is clear. So if you required a rename particular column, you can use. Otherwise, if you require offset, so what is the meaning of offset in a MySQL? Hello. Previously, I discussed this thing. In MongoDB, we are using SQL, sorry, version 5.0. Offset is option that is used to update the operation. Okay. Update, find any or you require modify. So, applied here, Okay. If this option is set to true, and the document found that match with the specific query, then update operation will update the match of single document or multiple documents. Clear? The use of assert here we indicate as a true. Okay, if the value of this option is set to true, document or document found match the specific query. Will match a specific query. Okay. And it will be modified. Comma assert is equal to. Okay. Last thing, the option can be required digitally. All this option should be practical. Very last thing that we discuss, how can we display? So, am I audible? Hello student, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me explain the last step to retrieve the record. Okay, display the result. In a SQL, we are using a select query. Okay. We are using a DBMS SQL query and display the record like a student table. So we use a select query, select star from student. Okay, it will display the result of a student table in a form of row and column. So here we require to display for NoSQL. Let me check how can we display. So again I copy all this query in a notepad. I copy only for if you require the record later on, so you can generate a record. Last thing I want to retrieve number of data. Okay, so db dot student. Okay, my database name is student. I want to find some specific condition. Okay, so I write find, then I want to perform a print operation for a particular JSON. So for each, then you can write a function. I want to write print function, okay, and print JSON. Let me check. Function is not a then I required a db dot student, then find specific criteria. Okay, so we use here rating. Okay, what is the use of this thing?
I will explain. Okay, let me complete this whole script before run this program. Okay, so generally this method is provided in MongoDB like a method to specify the cursor object or display the result in a easy to read attractive format. Okay, we want to read all the result in attractive format, so this function is useful DT. Okay, now next one I required a db dot student, then find a record. So by this way you can search a record. Second, I require db dot student find with a specific criteria. Okay, name like this way, the bracket s name we applied. Name already we mentioned RKS. Okay. Then again you can search by using for each operation. So for each operation, right here print JSON. Print JSON is available here. So next I want to search a record or retrieve the record, so write a student dot find as name s name we already covered, so s id, then colon, I required id dollar sign, so to get id but two. Okay. I will check only if any error will occur, so I will modify this value. Then to declare a variable, I required a variable and my variable name is a my st. Okay, or my stud, I created this is equal to db dot student dot I want to find, so find with a specific criteria here s name. Okay. I required this gt value of 2. Okay, this is the value for s id. Now condition is look like this. You can create a condition by simple using a while, and here we use a variable my stud dot as next. Okay, then print particular text. So I write here to JSON and the variable name is my stud. Okay, So this is for generating the query. The find query will be run with the query assistant. Okay. It will display the result. Look like this. Okay. We work on a second thing. So it generates a second query. And this is the last one. We use a condition. Okay. Clear? Clear, all of you? This is only document, okay, generated here. So it generates a result. Look like this. Okay, you can search by using this way. And again, you want to check. So I copy this thing. Don't worry if you run and found any error. So I will solve in the next lab. Last only we required a display database. So by using the show database, okay. Show DBS is used to show the database. Okay. So we are working on this database, student database. Okay. If modification of this database will covered, like so it will be displayed with a modified value. So this value in a DB, okay, right now not modified generally, but if you run on a large database, so it will definitely modify. Okay, so like this way your second practical you can perform. And if you found any error, so it will display here this error from, otherwise you can perform properly. Okay, your table view, if you want to check in a JSON, so it will display the JSON object. Okay, this is a JSON object. You can change here for a tree object, so it look like a tree or document. Okay, tree field we are created. Now all of you write down your enrollment number and enrollment number underscore name for attendance.